compete at a qualifying national competition. So I explored options of wearing full clothing and not having a competitive advantage over other competitors. Lawyers and coaches advised the Stevens Act provides for reasonable religious accommodations, but the path remained unclear as this was new territory and had never been requested. Through the overwhelming tide of support from press and the public, who came to know my story via care, my appeal was brought to the International Weightlifting Federation. I was astonished and grateful in how the media helped spread my story around the world. The appeal was monumental as it affects 25% of the world's population, or 1.6 billion Muslims worldwide. If you learn one thing from my presence here today, I want you to understand in the power of people to bring about change. Believe in yourself, the power of the individual. Any goal takes hard work. Regardless of the results, we always learn from the journey. Some of my personal journeys have been completing my PhD dissertation in electrical and computer engineering, working towards a Taekwondo black belt, and weightlifting. Challenging journeys, not stereotypically expected. So culture and society defines my choices as a woman, and more so as a Muslim woman, as not fitting a stereotype. But religiously, women have the capacity and are meant to be strong and should seek learning and education. History has examples of such women. Unfortunately, women of all cultures and societies are defined and valued more so for their appearance than their intellect and accomplishments. One of the advantages of sports, and on the same token education, is that it builds confidence. I hope my story can inspire and help women. Boundaries still need to be broken in all parts of the world and sectors of society, but the progress is promising. With my education, I hope to also work and collaborate in humanitarian applied research. That drive to educate and research improvements to real-world problems propelled me to pursue a PhD. One area of personal interest is human trafficking, which is an area I am happy to see the State Department focus on. My focus is on the technology aspect and how people use the internet and cellular networks to advertise and communicate with clients. Research is needed to find effective ways to track this activity. I hope that representing Pakistan at international competitions will help foster more female involvement in sports. It is not about finishing on the winner's podium, but getting to the starting line. Sports should be an activity that the girl in diapers, the next generation, would be familiar with and consider, not something that she has to pioneer. My father's passion for helping people and making a difference was the driving force of becoming an award-winning surgeon and family doctor. My father emphasized education and hard work, and my mother diligently supported my siblings and me in this incredible quest from the rural villages of northern Pakistan to these American shores. Our narrative is unbelievable, as I would never have guessed where these events would lead us. Just stop and think for a moment that you have standing before you is the daughter of two people from a remote region of Pakistan. This is what makes America great and what makes Pakistan great. You never know what will happen in your life or how you can make a difference, so you have to try with good intentions. One of the things I realized in Ramadan is being thankful for what you have, and that by challenging yourself, especially when you're training in sports, you become stronger spiritually, mentally, and physically. This year, it came at a time for me that I needed those reminders, and I want to give thanks to God, family, my parents, sisters, Shivana Farhan, my brother, Saqib and Nayab, my friends, especially Nadia Saad Ali, teachers, coaches, and all the others I haven't mentioned by name who have supported me in all of my journeys. I wish everyone a very happy Eid. Assalamu alaikum, and thank you for having me. Very inspiring and very much American. Now,